Hey, what's up guys? I'm back with another video, and in today's video, wait a second, I have to move this away from here. What the? In this video, I'll show you a simple solution to a problem with emissive lights inside Lumion. I never noticed this myself until a user named Kurosh messaged me on Instagram saying, "Quick question, how do you use hidden light in Lumion for curved designs? We can use emissive material, but if you can see them, they won't render, right? Do you find any solution for this matter?" He means this type of designs which have hidden lights facing the wall. So I went further to investigate this issue and found out that if the plane in which you have the emissive material is not facing directly the render camera, then it won't render any light. So in this video, I'll show you how you can go from this to this with a very simple technique. So let's get started. So I have here my scene inside Lumion, and what I'm going to do. Oh, by the way, I just launched my Lumion course. It's an in-depth course in which I'm showing you all the techniques I use to achieve high quality renders with Lumion. I'll leave a link in the description below this video. I have here already the emissive material to the back, as you can see. So it should give some light. You know, the light would hit the wall and create this halo effect, like we've seen in those photos. But if I go and take a render, let's see. I'm gonna do this one time. You see, no light is coming from behind these panels. So we have nothing. So we could fix this several ways. One could be we could add some spotlight to the back and try to match it the best possible, but by experience it's not easy to do that. Another way could be an area light. This area light is easier to do, but I don't think it's the ideal solution, but I'll still show you how this would look. So more or less like this, and like this. And then I will just decrease this more or less like so, like a square shape, and increase this, make it yellowish, and I will go here and inside, okay, and move it down. Okay, increase the brightness. So this could be a solution, and it will look more or less like this. Let's see. So you see now, like this, we have this effect on the back a little bit, but first you will need to do this to every shape. And second, if you would have something like, let's say, like this effects here, let me open this. So like this effect, you know, with these shapes, or actually this one is better to see. Or this. So what would mean is that you will have to go and duplicate each light and it make it like very small and duplicate. I don't think it's a nice way to work. So that's why we have the emissive material, right? So what I like to do is go here to the back and I will just duplicate this material. Not duplicate, I will copy it and paste here on the front. So okay, so now it's facing the camera, the emissive material, and I'll just take a new render. So you see now we have on each panel we have this backlight hitting the wall. So what we need to do now, we need to have a mask, so it's easier for us to select this all these panels, because we are going to edit this now in Photoshop, okay? So what we can do is go again to render. I'm just going to select this one, material ID map, okay? And let me just render it again.
Okay, now we have our material ID, and I'm gonna go to Photoshop, and inside Photoshop I have the material ID, the second render with the emissive lights facing the camera, and the ones without. So what I'm going to do is that I'm gonna copy this one and paste here. Then I'm gonna copy the material ID and I'm gonna do the same thing. And also, let me just quickly crop this out like this. Crop, okay. So now what I want to do, I want to just keep this part here, because if you see on those images, let's see. See, you have the light on the back, and then we have this part is not lit. So what we'll do, not here, Photoshop, we'll use this material ID to create our mask. So just with a quick selection tool and with the enhanced edge selected, I'll just with the mouse drag around like this. Okay, let me just see if it needs any refinements. Here you can just click Alt and remove. If it's not very well, so you can just use the lasso tool and just make it more or less like so. Now what we need to do, go to feather, 1 pixel, deselect this layer, and here just press the mask on the bottom. Okay, now we are almost done. Another thing we need to do is to control click the mask, so it will create a selection for us. Go to select and modify, contract, let's say 5 pixels. We also want to feather this, so let's feather 5 pixels. And now let's start erasing a little bit on this area. So we're gonna select this larger brush and opacity about 25. And we're going to invert it. Okay, and now gonna just start erasing these areas, so it creates a little bit of this glow around the shape, so it's not too perfect. Okay, and this is the before and after. So, and then after this, you can just create a new layer and image, apply image, and from here you can just go and start making all your edits, color correction, all of this. So, and this is my final result. So since Lumion has this limitation, this is a quick way, an easy way, to achieve the same result as you saw in those pictures.
If you found this video helpful, give me a thumb up, subscribe, and click the bell button to get notified when I publish my new videos.